Hi, very good morning. I'm Dr. Janak Patel, MD, general physician. I'm not a cardiologist. Today we'll be discussing on a topic which is one of the type of congenital heart disease. We call it the dextrocardia. Definition of dextrocardia, it is a malposition of the heart where the heart is situated on the right side of the chest and apex is pointing towards right side, meaning it is a mirror image of a normal position, and normal position is called levocardia. Just opposite of that on the right side we call it the dextrocardia. Suppose if the entire mediastinum is pushed or pulled towards the right side, that is called dextroposition. That is not dextrocardia. So it is on a vertical axis, there is a rotation of the heart, and that produces apex pointing towards the right side. We'll call that as dextrocardia. And while looking at the dextrocardia, you should look at the mark. You can see here, this is an R mark and apex is towards the right side. So this is dextrocardia. And along with that, you have to look at the position of the gastric bubble. This is gastric bubble. Gastric bubble is on the right side. It has to be on the left side. So there is also a rotation of the abdominal structure. So it is dextrocardia with situs inversus. The word utilizes situs inversus. You can see this is a typical dextrocardia. So in a normal position, apex is pointing towards the left side. RV is inferior, LV is anterior and superior. Same position, but it is pointing towards right side. So this is called mirror image dextrocardia. Mirror image dextrocardia. So this is the position. This will be RV will be inferior, LV will be superior, and apex will be pointing towards right side. So it is a rotation of the heart. You can classify all the different name utilized. You can utilize the word isolated dextrocardia, meaning there is only mal rotation of the heart. But viscera, that is abdominal viscera, is not rotated. Then we use the word isolated dextrocardia with situs solitus. And when the abdominal viscera is also rotated, we call situs inversus. And then we use the word complete dextrocardia. So it is a dextrocardia with situs inversus. The word good number of time it is utilized, complete situs inversus. There is one another terminology called cartilaginous syndrome. It is dextrocardia with agenesis of frontal sinus, ethmoidal sinus, so sinus agenesis, bronchiectasis, and may be associated with involvement of pancreas and other structures. There is another term which is being utilized, that is depending on the malposition of abdominal viscera. There is a word called heterotaxy and situs ambiguus. We'll be discussing in detail. Heterotaxy may be malposition of viscera along with abnormality of a spleen. Maybe asplenia, maybe multiple spleen, polysplenia. Spleen may be absent, spleen may be multiple. And ambiguous is a rotation, incomplete rotation of the viscera. You can have normal position of the heart, that is levocardia. Along with that, you can have a situs inversus. Or you can have a heart not completely rotated to right side. It is apex is behind the sternum. Then we call it a mesocardia. It is not levo, it is not dextro. So it is called mesocardia. And if the heart is outside the chest trough, then it is called as ectopia cordis. These are all the different terms which are being utilized in malposition of or malrotation of heart. So you can see this is right side, this is dextrocardia, this is again right side, apex is towards the right side, dextrocardia. Here there is a dextrocardia with, if you see, this is on the left side. So this is dextrocardia with situs solitus. This is dextrocardia, this is right side, this is levocardia with situs, this is levo with situs inversus. You can see this is pointing towards left side, normal position. So this is a levocardia and this is situs inversus. This has to be here. Instead of that, it is on the right side. So gastric bubble is on the right side. So stomach is on the right side. So that is situs inversus. And there is a levocardia. So levocardia with situs inversus. So these are some of the malposition of heart. There is one word which is utilized is dextroversion and dextrorotation. So there is a rotation of the heart around vertical axis so that the left ventricle lies anterior to the right ventricle. So it is called dextroversion or dextrorotation. Dextro position, I've already told you that it is because of shift of mediastinum. Apex still points towards the left side, but mediastinum is shifted to the right side, either because of right side fibrosis, collapse or thickened pleura, or left side massive pleural effusion, left side tension pneumothorax. That will shift the mediastinum to the right side and apex will be still pointing towards left. While classical mirror image dextrocardia means the position is along the vertical axis, anatomical position along the vertical axis, and that is apex is pointing towards right side. This all this word we have utilized: isolated dextrocardia, dextrocardia with situs solitus, dextrocardia with situs inversus, situs ambiguous, heterotaxy, mesocardia, levocardia, ectopic cordis, dextro position, which is shift of mediastinum. So these are all the different positions which we have discussed before. Now if you look at the percentage and how many percentage and percentage of congenital heart disease. So if there is a dextrocardia with situs solitus, if it is with levocardia, it is less than 1%, but see with dextrocardia and there is a situs solitus, 95%. If there is a situs inversus with dextrocardia, means we call mirror image and complete, then percentage of congenital heart disease is 3 to 5%. But if there is a levocardia with situs inversus, percentage of congenital heart disease is 100%. Ambiguous, or we use the word heterotaxy, there is levo position with polysplenia, 90%, and dextro variety with asplenia, that is 99 to 100%. Indirectly, there is a very high chance of congenital heart disease if there is a dextrocardia with situs solitus, levocardia with situs inversus and situs ambiguous. If you come across this variety, there is a very, very high chance of congenital heart disease. So in all those conditions, you can have congenital heart disease. Now this is a diagrammatic way shown. This is normal levo position. Stomach is on the left side. So this is normal position and there is a situs solitus. So we call levocardia with situs solitus. But if apex is pointing towards left side, it is levo. And if it is pointing towards right side, we call it as a dextro. And stomach is on the right side. So both are rotating. Mediastinum, that is cardiac, as well as abdominal viscera. So it is called situs inversus with dextrocardia. So this is typical mirror image. In this particular variety, the chances of congenital heart disease is only 3 to 5%. While if the person has got dextrocardia with situs solitus, the chances is 95%. And if there is a situs inversus with levocardia, the chances is 95 to 99%. So the incidence of congenital heart disease here will be 1 to 5%. In this variety, chance will be 3 to 5%. And in this two, the chance of congenital heart disease, that is situs solitus with dextrocardia or situs inversus with levocardia. So in this two condition, the chance of congenital heart disease will be 95 to 100%. So this is typical situs solitus. You can see that this is normal position of abdominal viscera. That is, liver is on the right side, stomach is on the left side, spleen is on the left side, ileocecal junction and appendix on the right side. So this is situs solitus and position of the heart is normal. In this particular condition, you can see this is normal. Levo with situs solitus. So this is normal. In this normal condition, the chance of congenital heart disease is only 3 to 5%. But if person has got situs solitus with dextrocardia, chances of congenital heart disease is almost close to 100%. It is 98%. Some series says 99%. So if there is a dextrocardia with situs solitus, it is 99% of congenital heart disease. If there is a dextrocardia with situs inversus, we call it as a mirror image. And total, situs inversus totalis. In that particular condition, again, the incidence of congenital heart disease is 3 to 5%, like a normal person. But if there is a dextrocardia with situs solitus, then the chance of congenital heart disease is 99%. So this is situs inversus with levocardia. The chance is 95%. You can see heart is in normal position, but there is a situs inversus, that is a malrotation of abdominal viscera, and that will produce 95% of chances of congenital heart disease. And if there is a bilateral asymmetry, meaning there is an asymmetry in abdominal viscera as well as there is an asymmetry in a rotation of the heart. In that particular condition, you will have a very high chance of congenital heart disease. So, visceral heterotaxy occurs in 0.8% of congenital heart disease. So, this is odd thing. There are two words commonly utilized. Heterotaxy means the different arrangement, while isomerism meaning bilateral asymmetry. And that is divided into right asymmetry, isomerism, where you have got an abnormal spleen like asplenia. And in a left side isomerism, there is an increased number of spleen. That is, we call polysplenia. And liver is typically transverse. Superior vena cava are typically bilateral and there is no perfect rigid relationship. And this we call as a heterotaxy. So if the person has got heterotaxy, the chances of congenital heart disease is 99%. So in a heterotaxy, you can see this is dextrocardia. Liver position is transverse but malrotated. Stomach is on the left side. Here it is on the right side. If the stomach is on the left side with polysplenia, this is L. You can see here, we label that as left isomerism. And if this is stomach is on the right side, it is called dextro isomerism, where you can have absence of spleen, and this is asplenia. In both conditions, the incidence of congenital heart disease is very, very high. But it is seen that in a left side isomerism with polysplenia, stomach on the left side, the chances of congenital heart disease is only 50%. So this is the little difference in heterotaxy variety. There is one variety which is called as ectopia cordis, where the heart is outside the chest wall. This is outside. The chances of congenital heart disease is very, very high, but mortality rate is also very, very high. The commonest cause of dextrocardia is genetic. It is autosomal recessive, where you get situs inversus, or we call mirror image or complete situs inversus with dextrocardia. There is one another condition where you come across dextrocardia is called Carter-Jenner syndrome. It is situs inversus variety of dextrocardia, where person can have Carter-Jenner syndrome, that is along with dextrocardia, you can have a agenesis of or mucosal ciliary abnormality in sinuses. So combined together, if you put a picture, dextrocardia with situs inversus or a complete variety, or we use a total variety, or we use a word mirror image, 3 to 5% means 97% of the time person heart is normal. But if it is with situs solitus, 90% congenital heart disease. Situs ambiguous, 100%. In a Carter-Jenner syndrome, along with dextrocardia, there is sinus agenesis, cystic bronchiectasis. But congenital heart disease, again, here is 3 to 5%. Mesocardia, 90% of congenital heart disease. Levocardia, normal. Again, we can call that 1 to 5%. Ectopia cordis, 100%. Heterotaxy in levo position or asplenia. Sorry, dextro position or asplenia variety, where stomach is on the right side and there is absence of spleen, chances of congenital heart disease is 100%. But if there is a levo position of stomach, polysplenia is common and congenital heart disease incidence is only 50%. So this is roughly what you can come across in a clinical picture. So in a clinical picture, apex beat is on the right side. S1 is better heard on the apex, and fifth intercostal space on the right side. S2 is better heard on the right side sternal notch. Abdominal organs are seen on the opposite side if there is a dextrocardia with situs inversus. So liver will be on the right side, liver will be on the left side, stomach will be on the right side, and ileocecal junction and appendix will be in a left iliac fossa. So that will be typical finding what you will come across. Spleen will be on the right side along with stomach. So this is dextrocardia with situs inversus, or we also use about situs inversus totalis, or mirror image dextrocardia, or total situs inversus with dextrocardia, etc. These are the common word utilized. Carter-Jenner syndrome, or maybe associated with dextrocardia with situs inversus. And in that case, you can have agenesis of frontal sinus, ethmoidal sinus. There may be one another associated condition in dextrocardia with situs inversus is biliary atresia. So these are the two additional abnormality you can come across, biliary atresia and Carter-Jenner syndrome. So you should look for that. In a situs solitus With dextrocardia, chances of congenital heart disease is very, very high, like VSD, coarctation of aorta, atrial septal defect, pulmonary venous congestion, or a pulmonary venous connection, that is total anomalous or partial anomalous pulmonary venous drainage, complete atrioventricular septal defects, etc., are very, very common. In a ECG, what you come across, and in a radiography, we have already mentioned that in a radiography, apex will be pointing towards right side with trachea center. So that will be typical. And if you look at the gastric bubble, if it is on the left side, situs solitus. If it is on the right side, situs inversus. So that will be on a radiology. In an ECG, we'll show you that particular part, that if you look in a V1 to V6, the RV progression is poor. But if you take the leads on the right side, V3R, V4R, V5R, V6R, there's a gradual increase in the voltage suggesting dextroposition. Sorry, dextrocardia. Dextrocardia. And if you look in a limb leads, lead 1 will be inverted. AVR will show you upright waves. AVL will be also opposite. It will be showing you inverted leads. Will be just showing you that particular. Situs inversus with dextrocardia is also associated with normal incidence of congenital heart disease, that is 3 to 5%. Carter-Jenner syndrome, I've already mentioned that it is associated with bronchiectasis, abnormal ciliary mucosa and sinuses, and may be associated with even cystic changes in pancreas, rare conditions. Usually we call as a triad in Carter-Jenner syndrome, situs inversus, dextrocardia, bronchiectasis with paranasal sinus ciliary cell abnormality. So on X-ray, you can easily make out chest X-ray that there is a dextrocardia with situs inversus. Echocardiography can also confirm the position on the right side. And if the paranasal sinus X-ray is taken, you can get agenesis or abnormal paranasal sinus and sinusitis. If you come across pure isolated levocardia, normal position with situs inversus or situs ambiguous, the chances of congenital heart disease is very, very high. Mesocardia is also very high chance of getting congenital heart disease, almost 95 to 99%. As far as investigation is concerned, we already shown you that X-ray chest, ECG and echo will be best. And to rule out Carter-Jenner syndrome, PNS, paranasal sinuses, bronchography to have an evidence of bronchiectasis, or it can be confirmed by HRCT or CT scan or MRI. So ECG becomes a very useful and X-ray chest becomes very useful. So on an X-ray chest, if you see a dextroposition, apex towards the right side, it is more in favor of dextrocardia. Always look, see, this is L mark, so this is left side, so heart is on the right side, so this is a dextrocardia. Now look at the stomach bubble. If you can identify a stomach bubble, here there is a stomach bubble here, so that shows you that there is situs inversus. So chances of congenital heart disease is only 2 to 3%, maximum 5%. Now here if you see, simultaneously, there is a steel wire, suture wires. You can see here, these are suture wires. There is a cardiomegaly, and these are suture wire, means some surgery has been done. Some surgery has been done. And if you see here, there is a thickening of the pleura. So all this suggests that dextrocardia is present with some congenital heart disease and where surgery has been done. So this is typical, very, very typical. Dextrocardia is there, but stomach bubble is on the right side. On the left side. So there is no rotation of abdominal viscera. So we call isolated dextrocardia. So if there is an isolated dextrocardia or isolated dextrocardia with situs solitus, then this particular person has got a very high chance of having congenital heart disease. Now you can see here, this is left mark. This is on the right side. This x-ray is put in a reverse pattern. Actually, this should be here. So this is dextrocardia and this is on the right side. Stomach bubble is on the right side. So this is dextrocardia with situs inversus. Chances of congenital heart disease are 3 to 5% only, like a normal. Now in an ECG, what happens in a normal? You can see here, this is what we have to attach. Right arm, left arm, right foot, left foot. But in a dextrocardia, this becomes right arm, this becomes left arm. And this remains same. This remains same. But the leads are changed. So what changes you get in an ECG, we'll show you that. And if you want to demonstrate that heart is on the right side, you will have to take V3R, V4R, V5R, V6R. R wave will gradually increase and this will tell you that heart is on the right side. Now, you can see here that lid 1 here is inverted and in AVL also it is inverted, while in AVR it is upright. And if you see here, there is a gradual, this V1, S wave is tall. Here, there is no progress of R wave. But if you look here, when you take V3R, V4R, V5R, V6R, there is a gradual increase in R wave. This suggests that there is dextrocardia. So, this particular way you can identify in an ECG. If you want to suspect, if in an ECG in AVR you get an R wave and lead 1 you get inverted, do suspect two things possibility. One, dextrocardia, and second, reversal of the leads, limb leads. So in by mistake, suppose if the left arm lead is attached to right and right arm lead is attached to left side, then it will produce what we call as technical dextrocardia. So you should try to look at that. And in presence of such changes, say if AVR is upright and lead 1 is inverted, but there is a normal progress of R wave, that is V1 is showing you a small R with a deep S wave and V5, V6 is showing you a tall R wave with a small S wave, or only R wave, there is no S wave, this is technical dextrocardia. So here we'll show you that. You can see in lead 1, it is inverted. In AVR, it is upright. In AVL also, it is inverted. And if you look in V1 to V6, there is no R wave progression. So V3 to V6, R wave voltage are decreasing. And if you take in V3 to V6 R, if you get that particular leads, then R wave voltage will be increasing. That will tell you that this is true dextrocardia. So in AVR, if you get an upright QRS complex and V1 is showing you a deep S wave, and gradually, if you see here, the S wave is persisting, but there is no progress of R wave. This suggests that there is dextrocardia. In lead 1 and AVR, This is normal ECG. You can compare now. Here, this is upright. AVR is negative. So lead 1 and AVL are upright. AVR is negative. And if you look here, now there is a gradual increase in the R wave. You can see that there is gradual. So this is normal progress. So this is normal ECG. Now look here. Lead 1 inverted, AVL inverted. Look at AVR. Not very tall. Not very tall. Clear? So lead 1 and AVL has become inverted. By and large, in AVR, you might get a little R wave prominent. But look here, there's a normal R wave progression. So this limb leads are reversed. So this is also called as a technical dextrocardia. Inverted P wave and QRS in lead 1 and also in AVR. So arm leads, if they are inverted in lead 1 and AVL, you will get inverted, and in AVR you will get upright QRS complex. And when you correct it, you can see back lead 1 AVL is upright, AVR all complexes are inverted. So this is limb reversal, or sometimes we use the word technical dextrocardia. So you can easily understand. So whenever the limb reversal takes place, it will give rise to the technical dextrocardia. So AVR and AVL are interchanged, and lead 2 and lead 3 are interchanged. So that I already told you. Now this is important, because if a person is having dextrocardia while giving a defibrillation, the pad position should be reversed so that you get a better results for defibrillation. As far as management is concerned, if there is no congenital heart disease, you don't require any treatment. But depending upon the congenital heart disease, treatment will change. And the important part for a surgeon, if there is a situs inversus, the organ position should be remembered and you should operate accordingly. So always surgeon finds little problem if he is not informed that what a person is having. So person should be informed prior to surgery that so and so person is having dextrocardia with situs inversus, or dextrocardia with situs solitus, or situs ambiguus, heterotaxy, etc. should be informed, or should be investigated, and then surgery should be done. So I end my lecture here on dextrocardia. I hope this will be helpful to you. No doubt in your exam, it is only 5 marks short note. But once in a while, you will come across a person with dextrocardia, and the common condition which you will come across in your everyday practice will be dextrocardia with situs inversus, where the chances of congenital heart disease is only 3 to 5%. But in another variety of dextrocardia, that is dextrocardia with situs solitus, or isolated dextrocardia, mesocardia, levocardia with situs inversus, heterotaxy or situs ambiguus, in all this variety, the chances of congenital heart disease is high, and they will be having symptom signs early. So remember that, it will be helpful to you in your everyday practice. See you in next lecture.